Here's what I feel is the most important question to ask an emergency medicine physician. This is the most important question to ask. As a PA of 23 years, worked a lot of emergency medicine, okay? I've worked in traditional settings where there's a board-certified ER doc right here. I've worked a lot by myself. I've taught a lot of emergency medicine. Here's what I feel is the most important question to ask an emergency medicine doctor. Now, if you're like me, you've been to lots of conferences, lots of CME conferences, had a lot of exposure to educational content. And one of the things that I realized, especially when I was critical access emergency medicine, I always wanted to go to physician CME conferences. I wanted to think at a higher standard of care. I felt that I would get more out of CME programs that were designed for physicians. So I don't think I ever went to a PA conference. It was always an emergency medicine board of view course or some kind of emergency medicine course for physicians. And I struggled a little bit. Because like taking advanced trauma life support. I could hear a great physician give a talk on putting in a chest tube, and it was a great talk, okay? Super powerful talk. And they'd talk about putting a chest tube in, and all the residents and ER docs around me would shake their heads, and I failed to realize how much pressure it took to punch through the pleura, okay, until I did it myself. So the docs around me knew it, but I didn't because I didn't have that training. I didn't have a residency program. I didn't have that degree of gross anatomy that they did. So there was always things that was a little bit over my head that at times I'd have to, hey, I don't get it. So one of the things I realized is that there are a lot of emergency medicine conferences, a lot of physician educators that have unbelievably good knowledge. They can quote every study, every medication to use for a migraine headache. They know it. And that's good if you're a doc. As a PA, this is the most important question to ask an emergency medicine doctor is, how do you think about headaches? Tell me about how you process your thought process. So yeah, there's a bunch of medications to use for a migraine, but how do you process which one to use? How do you think about it? How do you use the literature to support your clinical decisions? How do you think about a headache in terms of who do I need to scan and who don't I have to scan? How do you think about headaches when it comes to doing an LP or not? Now, one of the things that I've always stressed in teaching medicine is the process, okay? And I preach that how we teach is what we teach, okay? Whether it's board review, emergency medicine, urgent care, EKG interpretation. How we teach is what we teach. So how do we teach? We teach thought processes. We teach how to take the evidence-based medicine and apply it as an advanced practitioner to stay out of trouble. So you don't get burned. You don't get burned by a certified letter in a lawsuit or an unexpected bad outcome. I mean, we all know there's two catastrophic outcomes. Number one is you see a patient and then there's a bad outcome that you didn't expect, an unexpected bad outcome. That's one catastrophe. The second one is if you get a certified letter because of it. So there's two different ways we have to think. Now, back to the original question. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to challenge you to often ask the docs, tell me how you're thinking. Don't just quote me data. Don't quote me literature. How do you apply that? And that's really the art of medicine. That's something that I really believe is missing from a lot of emergency medicine education, is to help me to understand how to think. Help me to understand why these algorithms are in place. So it's not rote memorization. I understand the why behind it. Okay? So it's CME for life. That's what I do when I teach emergency medicine. I teach thought processes. How do you think about chest pain? Okay, I preach there's five causes of chest pain. Who's your papa? PA, PPA. There's five causes of chest pain. Pericarditis, acute coronary syndrome, pneumothorax, PE, and an aneurysm. Beautiful. There's five causes of chest pain that are lethal. There's five causes of shortness of breath or cough. Don't make a horrid mistake. HORID, heart obstruction, reactive infection, or death. Those are thought processes. If you apply them, it's going to give you really solid fundamentals that are just time-tested and will really have you earn the respect of the supervising docs that you work with. They're like, hey, he's really processing things at a high level. So I hope that helps, but that's a question that I would challenge you as a PA nurse practitioner is start asking, how do you think about headaches, not just the meds? How do you think about the selection and what do you do? Cool. My name is John Blitzky from CME for Life. Our whole goal is to help you maximize your mind. Good luck and God bless.